Okay, thank you very much for your attendance earlier today at our committee meetings. First item on the agenda, our invocation. We have Associate Chaplain Tammy Sparks. Tammy, are you here? Tommy. Hold on, man.
Tom. Keep his glasses on.
Tommy, how are you, Tom? I'm sorry.
Thank you. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this day and for the privilege you've given us to live in this great country of ours, and also the privilege of living in this great county. For we know your word says that there's wisdom in a multitude of counsel. Well, that's why this group meets together tonight to have wisdom. And we pray for your discernment that they would make decisions that would continue to protect and prosper this county. Thank you for these gathered together, the freedom we have to gather together for such a meeting as this. Father, we pray your blessing upon this meeting, upon this country, upon this county, and all that's done, we give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Tommy. Next, we have our pledge. Bob, do you lead us in the pledge?
Yes, sir. We got that.
Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Bob. Next, we have presentations, and the first is presentation of Safety Award, the Service Award, Sustained Excellence and Risk Management. And this is presented by John Henderson and Mr. Terry Booker, our risk manager here to receive. So Mr. Henderson, Mr. Booker.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman, members of council. Administrator O'Neill, it's a pleasure to be here, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John Henderson with the Association of Counties. I'm the Director of Risk Management Services. On January 25th at our Insurance Trust membership meeting, we presented four awards to Spartanburg County. I think y'all probably remember I was up here the past couple of years doing about the same thing. Now, I wouldn't be here if y'all weren't continuing to improve every year. So that's a great thing. The first award that we have is the Service Award, which goes to Terry Booker. And we present this award each year to members of our insurance trust that do over and above to promote risk management within their community and among the members of the insurance trust. I'm here to tell you tonight that Mr. Booker is a great resource for the South Carolina counties workers' comp trust and the staff of the Association of Counties. And he's the one that a lot of people ask questions to, and he's always got a helpful answer, and he goes out of his way to help other folks. So we really appreciate it, and we present it in the Service Award.
Thank you.
The next award is the Sustained Excellence in Risk Management Award, which we presented a number of times to Spartanburg County. This award is presented to a county that continues to show high levels of excellence and improvement from year to year in their risk management program. So the Sustained Excellence Award. The next award is the Outstanding Safety Achievement Award. This award was presented for the work that y'all did in making sure that the deputies driving those explorers were free from car. And the final award is, I think, the one that a lot of people get interested in. This is the second runner-up for lowest experience modification factor. I know that's a mouthful, but in short, the experience modification factor is really the report card on your safety and risk management program, and it is a factor that goes into multiplying the final premium to give you your final premium result. This year, your experience modifier was 0.68. That doesn't mean anything, but $156,000 in savings on your workers' comp premium over what an average county would be with a normal zero modifier, 1.0 modifier means a lot. So $156,000 in savings for the citizens of Spartanburg County. And I want to thank everyone on council and all the employees for their continued dedication to risk management, and especially to y'all for your support to make this possible. Thank you very much for y'all's continued membership in the Association of Counties and your great support for this name.
Thank you, John. Thank you. Have a safe trip home, Mr. Boker. You and the employees of Spartanburg County, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
I don't know of too many places that's got a modifier that low. I mean, when you start talking about getting below 0.9, it's something else.
Righty, item B. Resolution proclaiming March 2018 is prescribed fire awareness program. This will be presented by Mr. Whitney Farr. Mr. Farr. Matt Barrington, the Natural Resources Commission Service Conservatives, now Bonnie Wines, District Coordinator, Spartanburg Southern Water, and Commissioner Senator Eubanks and Dr. Jack Turner here to receive. Mr. Farr.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We have tonight a resolution proclaiming March 2018 as prescribed fire awareness month in Spartanburg County. Whereas Spartanburg County Council recognizes that prescribed fire provides multiple ecological and economic benefits to the citizens of Spartanburg County, prescribed fire is a traditional land management practice and public safety tool that helps prevent and lessen the severity of wildfires, reducing the loss of private property and saving lives while acting as a preventative measure, saving taxpayers the cost and hazards of local governments, public safety, and firefighting officials who respond to wildfires. And whereas prescribed fire is a valuable tool used by forest landowners and managers in reducing hazardous fuels, reducing the risk of destructive wildfires, preparing sites for both natural and artificial forest regeneration, improving access to and the appearance of land, and controlling detrimental insects and forest diseases. Prescribed fire is used to restore and maintain fire-dependent ecosystems and to manage wildlife habitat for many species. Many rural economies depend on prescribed fire to manage habitat for game species such as white-tailed deer, wild turkey, and bobwhite quail, whose hunting economy is vital to South Carolina. Prescribed fire is used to manage for songbirds and other non-game wildlife species and for fire-dependent plants. South Carolina Fire Commission, Forestry Commission, is authorized by